What's up, guys? Greg here. Welcome to an episode of the Vinyl Rundown. Welcome, vinyl collectors and fans. This is a response to a contest from a new channel that I didn't know anything about, Shad from New Wave Vinyl. And his contest and challenge is about new wave music. And we have tons of that in my house, and I'll tell you why. It's not my fault. I'm going to give you some of my records and thoughts about the whole New Wave thing. New Wave was very big when I was younger, a long time ago. I was in high school and college during the sort of classic days of the New Wave movement. And I worked at record stores throughout the early 80s to probably 85 or 86. And actually, I had met my wife at a record store back then. So the fact that we have tons and tons of New Wave records is mostly on her side of the collection, not my side. I have some weird mixed feelings about the whole New Wave thing. There's lots of great bands out there. We're listening to The Jam, by the way. Paul Weller, one of the most brilliant songwriters of that era. And I went on to do the Style Council, a little mellower, jazzier version of Paul Weller tunes. So let's just get into some of these records, and maybe that'll clue me into some of the crazy things I want to tell you about. My thoughts about New Wave. Okay, so one of the things that has always bugged me about New Wave is it's all about the hairstyles. There's Flock of Seagulls, and there's Duran Duran. Ridiculous hairstyles and outfits and clothing and all that stuff. So that was one of my pet peeves about the whole New Wave movement, is it seemed to attract a lot of people who are into the hair and the outfits, and that's true of a lot of musical movements, but because I was experiencing that in high school, it was sort of really apparent to me that there were people who didn't really know the music that well, didn't really care about the music. Maybe they did, but they maybe were getting into the movement because of sort of an insecurity. That brings me to this guy, Adam Ant. There's very personal reasons for me telling you these stories. Adam Ant, the drummer that I played in a lot of bands with back in high school and college, he used to dress up like Adam Ant. And there was like a 6 month or 1 year period where he dressed like Adam Ant all the time. Got the funny hairdo things and the little cross earring and eye makeup and wacky clothing. At that time, he called this movement the New Romantic Movement. I don't know what that means, but so he dressed up like Adam Ant for a year, and then he dressed up like David Bowie for a year, and then he dressed up like Brian Ferry from Roxy Music for a year. And it was, you could tell that this person was like kind of searching for something and using these wacky hairdos to express themselves. One day he said, "Hey, I'm bisexual." I'm like, "No, you're not. You're just saying that because it's cool to be bisexual." Anyway, there's a lot of great music in the New Wave period, but my remembrance of it is kind of through the eyes of what was going on with some of the people around me. I will get into some more of the records here. I mean, Duran Duran. We got like 15 Duran Duran records. How many do we need? Flock of Seagulls, remember when they came out and they were huge on MTV? MTV movement was really huge back then too. New Order, Blue Monday. This is actually kind of a cool record. The whole synth poppy thing in New Wave music. Giant floppy disk. Actually, they did have floppy disks this big back in the olden days. You guys remember the 5-inch? They had a 7-inch and they had an even bigger one. Serious. Okay. Shad, he mentioned in his video, the first band that popped into his mind was Devo. And in this family, we are huge Devo fans. Why? My son is really into Devo. But Devo is one of these bands that I think, super creative. They're kind of a proto-punk band. They got pigeonholed into New Wave when I think they were about much more than that. So when Devo first started recording, they had a lot of weird tunes that were ended up sort of as basement tapes, and so 30 years later they came out with some of the stuff on record, the so-called hardcore. They really started out as this proto-punk art project. Look at our buddy Boogie Boy. So we saw them on this tour, the hardcore tour, 2014 or 2015, and Boogie Boy, which is Mark Mothersbaugh in a mask, comes out in a pink suit and a walker and stole the show. So if you're only into the sort of whippet stuff of Devo, you probably don't know about all this cool artsier, more weirder stuff that they did. Let's see. Here's a record that some of you, most of you probably don't know, don't recall. Gary Myrick and the Figures had a couple of power pop tunes in the 80s called, She Talks in Stereo, and what was the other one called? She Talks in Stereo and Guitar Talk, Love and Drums. Those tunes were featured in the Valley Girl movie, kind of probably made some money for him. There he is. So Gary Myrick just moved into our neighborhood a couple years ago, you know, within a couple miles from here. So he would end up doing a lot of shows at a club right down the street. We could walk up there and see him in a very intimate setting of like 12 people in a club. And here's my commentary on New Wave. New Wave, you know, started out with the punk and different movements, but the music industry really tried to pigeonhole people and say, we need to sell records, so you're gonna sound New Wave. We gotta put the right kind of hairdo on you and the right kind of clothing. You know, look at the sort of 80s outfits they're wearing. And we go to see Gary Myrick play at this little club, and he sounds nothing like 80s synth pop. It turns out he is an amazing, authentic Texas blues guitar wrangler aficionado. True Texas blues. He's in this little club playing the Stratocaster and slide guitar and doing all these blues numbers. He actually replaced Stevie Ray Vaughan in whatever band Stevie Ray Vaughan left to go have a solo career. So, my point is, a lot of artists seem to have their careers sidetracked by producers who wanted to sell a new wave sound and a new wave look. So the whole new wave movement is so stuck in the late 70s and 80s, unlike any other music genre. You know, some music genres are timeless. They are stuck in that decade like no other genre, my opinion. So another sort of subgenre of new wave is power pop. And one group that I love, the DBs, not that well known. Myself and Hannah on the vinyl community, we're the two biggest DBs fans out there. I talk about them any chance I get. Singer-songwriter team of Chris Stamey and Peter Holzhappel made a bunch of great records back in, I guess, late 70s, early 80s. The song Amplifier, you all know probably. And I saw the two of them play an acoustic set at McCabe's Guitar Shop in Santa Monica just a couple years ago. That was an awesome experience in terms of singer-songwriters and power pop. I don't think too many people can beat these guys, Difford and Tilbrook, the guys in Squeeze. Great songwriters. And again, they would have been songwriters with or without. They would have been great and successful with or without the trappings of the new wave hairstyles and clothing and all that. Because they were just great songwriters. Same thing could be said about Elvis Costello, Joe Jackson, a lot of other people. And if you want to go back to punk, this is Rodney on the Rock. KROQ was the big new wave radio station here in the 80s and 90s. They're still going strong today. But Rodney on the Rock, Rodney Bingenheimer, DJ, claims he probably discovered a bunch of groups. There's a cool compilation he put together of really sort of hardcore punk stuff. I don't know, is this record rare? It's got The Adolescents, Agent Orange, Black Flag, Circle Jerks, a bunch of other small-time bands I haven't heard of, but very cool compilation coming out of the LA punk scene, Rodney Bingenheimer. Oh, more power pop. How about 2020? Look Out, another one of my wife's records. Nuclear Boy, I think, was a hit for them. Okay, is that enough about New Wave? What else can I tell you about New Wave? We're still listening to The Jam. Not The Jam. Yeah, The Jam. We're still listening to The Jam over there live. Little secret, guys. You don't want to get hot copyright hits on your videos. Instead of playing the record, play a live concert off YouTube. This wasn't released on a record. No one cares. All right, Shad. What record would I have you listen to get you into a new style of music? I don't know. That's a very tough question for me. I listen to tons of jazz lately, and classical, and all kinds of weird stuff. I just grabbed this record out of the pile. It's one of the weirder records that I have. Sun. Heavy, dark, gothic, drone, metal band. Very bizarre. Listen to it on YouTube. See what you think. You probably won't like it. If you like pop music and power pop music, probably stay away. Stay away from Sun completely. They come out in these gothic robes and hoods, and there's a lot of smoke and steam, and it's all very dark and scary. But if you really want to get into that style of music, why not? Life Metal. That's a Record Store Day re-release. Okay, hobbies. I got hobbies. My hobbies, a lot of my hobbies are related to music. I'm going to grab some equipment over here to show you my hobby. Don't move. I'm coming, bro. There may be some noise here. I've always been into sort of the science and electronics of sound and acoustics and musical playback and audio. And I started building synthesizers. Here's one. This is called the, what's it called? What is this thing called? It's called the Thingamagoop. And I built it out of a kit. And you can play with it for hours. And this is the kit form exactly as it came out of the box. I mean, I had to do all the soldering of all the components. But, that's one of them. I'm going to show you another one. How do you turn this thing off? I'm going to show you another even cooler one. Can you hear that?
Sounds good, doesn't it?
This is loud. Holy crap, is it loud. So this is a kit I built from the circuit board and soldered in all the components, called the Nebulaphone from Bleep Labs. You can go online and look at the website for Bleep Labs. And they come out with these kits every year or so. They sell a few thousand. Once they're gone, they're gone. So buy them while they're there. Assemble them. So the Nebulaphone I wanted to put on a base of some sort. Otherwise, it's just sticking on these little spacer things. So I went out to the garage and got what I thought was the perfect CD. I found an MC Hammer CD, and I gave it a little gold paint, and I called it the MC Nebulaphone. And I drilled that puppy right through the CD. So those digital bits are just right in line with the synthesizer goodness. Anyway, this is a fairly sophisticated analog synthesizer, and it's noisy, or it doesn't have to be noisy. It has a little keyboard on here. That doesn't sound like anything. Nice little sequencer. Yeah. Play some hard rock guitar to that. The Nebula phone? Anyway, how do I tie that into my musical vinyl collecting? To me, it's all music. To me, that's music. Yeah, believe it or not. And, you know, play those notes on a saxophone, and you got a John Coltrane or an Ornette Coleman record. To me, music is about sound and waveforms, and it's not just about pop songs. There's a whole world of music out there that has to do with how we experience sound. And I like to kind of experiment on how you make sound, whether it's playing the guitar or screwing around with electronics. And I like to screw around with stereo equipment, speakers, and all that stuff. So to me, it's all kind of part of the hobby of music. Vinyl is an essential part of it, but why not? These are fun toys, but they're also musical instruments. And I've built four or five from this company, plus we bought some little synthesizers. I will do some more in-depth stuff on my synthesizer someday, but the synthesizer thing certainly ties into the synth pop of the 80s new wave. And actually, I kind of got into all these synthesizers because my son expressed this interest in Devo, which is one of his all-time favorite bands. So I got him a couple of synthesizers, built a couple of synthesizers for us to play with around the house. And what else can I say? Shad, congratulations on 100 subscribers. And didn't know about your channel until I saw Mazzy, Norman Maslov, do your contest entry. So contests, great way to spread the word about your channels out there, guys. And what else can I tell you? Thanks for watching. Keep it spinning, guys. Bye-bye.